The year was 2019, where it was announced that a beloved and obscure children's show called The Banana Splits would be brought back for a new generation. Technically, they already tried this before. They tried it with the web cartoons, they tried it back in 2008, and honestly, that was good enough for me. Sometimes you don't need like a big comeback for a show that was from the 60s, and for what they did with the Banana Splits at the time, it was pretty decent. Nothing too big, but just some small here and there reboots just to catch people's attention. But then in 2019, they f***ed it up! I have been wanting to review this movie for a long time. What kept me from doing it? Well, it's because I've just been going back and forth on whether I should or not. But since now nobody is talking about it anymore, I feel like now it's my turn for the spotlight on what I really think about this so-called movie. And before I start, if you do like this movie, that is perfectly fine. If you do like this new adaptation of the show, then good on you. But we should also respect those who don't like this new adaptation because they grew up with the original and they're expressing their own thoughts and not insult them. And I'm just giving a warning right now, I am probably gonna get so mad in this review because I promise you this, I am not gonna hold back on this. I am not gonna hold back on any anger I have towards this. And I might even throw in a few swear words here and there. Hey, I'm only human. So with that out of the way, let's get this over with. I figure before we talk about the movie, let's talk about the actual show itself. The Banana Splits Show, or the Banana Splits and Friends Show, was a live-action television series produced by Hanna-Barbera. Yes, that Hanna-Barbera, and was actually their first step into live action. The characters being the Banana Splits, Flegel the Beagle, Bingo the Ape, Drooper the Lion, and Snorky the Elephant. The show itself had a lot of slapstick humor, with in the middle being some songs and some cartoons thrown in on the side. Although the show itself didn't last for that long, airing between 1968 until 1970. But then again, that's kinda common, considering that a lot of Hanna-Barbera shows around that time don't last for that long. But all in all, this was a fun show to watch. The Banana Splits movie, however, is about a Five Nights at Freddy's theme where the characters are robots and they go around killing people. Hell, it's not even a parody. They just basically stole Five Nights at Freddy's but put the Banana Splits in their place. And the movie itself is very disrespectful to the show that it is based on. But before I get into my gripes about this, what's the plot? A young boy and his family goes to the studio where they tape the Banana Splits show to become a studio audience. The boy himself is a huge fan of the Splits, which makes me feel so bad for him for what's about to become. But little do they know that the show itself is about to be canceled. Once the Splits hear about this, they are not too happy. So they decide to kill everybody and kidnap all the kids so that they can force them to watch the show forever. And yeah, that's pretty much the whole plot. I mean, I know I probably skipped out on a few things, but I'm not going back to watch the movie just for this review. Alright, so let's talk about the downsides on this movie, which are a lot, by the way. And then we'll look at the bright sides, which are very few. One downside is the plot. The plot is very basic. So basic, in fact, that I can easily guess what's gonna happen in the next scene. Another thing, and I already mentioned this, is how very disrespectful this movie is to the actual show. Sure, they put in small Easter eggs here and there, but it's very brief and it's very little, where it really makes me wonder if these people actually watched the show before actually making this. For example, in the Banana Splits movie show, there is an obstacle course that seems to be played out like as if it's a game show. The original series was about these characters going around doing silly shenanigans and funny skits, not this double dare bullshit. And some of the characters are terrible, and I don't mean the Banana Splits themselves, I mean like the actual human cast. And no, I don't mean any disrespect to the actual actors, in fact, I kind of actually feel bad for them being in this piece of garbage. Heck, for all I know, the Banana Splits in the movie actually kidnapped them so they can force to be in this movie. Also, the acting is not great either. And speaking of characters, let's take a look at the Banana Splits themselves. First of all, the costume designs here are garbage. And no, I'm not just saying that because I hate the movie. Like, they are legitimately awful. They almost look like they're just fan-made, and they just look like direct copies from the 2008 reboot. Heck, for all I know, this could be a whole parody of the 2008 reboot than the actual show. At least that would make more sense. All characters of the Banana Split, except for Snorky, are voiced by Eric Bauza in this movie. And it's a... He tried kind of voice. But honestly, I don't see what's the point of even giving them lines since they barely talk in the movie. The only ones who get the most screen time are Flegel and Drooper, and even they get the most lines. Bingo only gets three. Three lines in the movie. And yet, he's in the main cover. He's taking up the whole space in the DVD cover. But yet, he's barely in it. He only gets like a few scenes in the movie. That don't make sense. The only character who is not fully evil is Snorky. And the way they present that is ridiculous. No, not even ridiculous, it's just stupid. The boy gets near him and he goes, "It's okay, it's Snorky, he's different." First, why do I feel like I heard that line somewhere else that made more sense than this? Because just saying that, oh, he's different, so he's a good guy, doesn't automatically make him redeemable. And yes, at the end, he does become a good guy and he even fights Bingo to save everybody, but that just comes off as so cheesy and a bit too forced. And don't get me started on the other characters, like Stevie. Who the hell is Stevie? Why is he here? Why is he a member on the show? Why does he exist? Sure, in the original series, they did have some real humans in the show, like the Sour Grape Punch or the Dilly Sisters, but they were just mostly short side characters. Stevie just feels like a pointless character that was added in the movie at the last second because, oh, we need to fill in another kill scene. Oh, and speaking of which, let's talk about some of the murder scenes in this movie, because most of them are just cheesy. And most are just so bad that you just want to look away. And not because the Banana Splits are actually killing people, but just how it's just sad and generic. One of those scenes which still piss me off to this day is the one where they do a banana split on one guy while he's chained up on a wheel. And what they mean is that they'll literally split him in half by grabbing on his arms and legs, pulling them while he screams in pain. Until they're ripped off. Oh, and this is performed in front of kids who are chained up and held against their will to watch this. Yeah, just thought I'd bring that up. This movie tries so hard to be disturbing and shocking, and it fails miserably bad. Disappointingly bad. Not disappointing as is, oh, this is just cheesy. No, disappointingly to where longtime original fans would be tearing up. Disappointed that Warner Brothers would actually approve on this shit, on this abomination of a movie. Now, real quick, let's talk about the bright sides of this movie, if there's any. One of the bright sides, well, some of the scenes, like when the Banana Splits are acting all serious while still having those goofy faces, are kind of funny. That whole scene with Snorky fighting Bingo is kind of hilarious because of how ridiculously bad it is. But that's pretty much it. I don't have any sympathy for this movie. It didn't need to exist. I mean, if you want to make a Five Nights at Freddy's movie about something like this, then that's fine. But why the Banana Splits? Just why? What's next? Puffin stuff? I apologize if I'm sounding and acting so angry right now, but I really am. This movie offends me badly. This movie, the fact that it even exists, boils my blood. The fact that this was actually made and was so disrespectful to the original franchise, it's just heartbreaking, to me at least. This is not the Banana Splits I grew up with. The ones I grew up with, which was on Boomerang, I grew up with funny characters and with funny personalities. This is just a cash grab. A cash grab on a movie based on the video game that is similar to this. That should have come out years ago, but it finally decides to come out now? Yes, I'm talking about the Five Nights at Freddy movie that's coming out soon. What the hell took that so long? You know, maybe if that would have came out sooner, we wouldn't get pieces of garbage like this, or ripoffs. This movie is awful. Terrible. It has no right to exist. Like, even forgetting the fact that it's a Banana Splits movie, the whole thing is just terrible. It's basic. Watching this feels like a chore to get through. It is a complete waste of time. And I do not recommend anyone to watch this. Nobody. I mean, if you want to, then go ahead. I'm not stopping you. But watch at your own risk, because this is a waste of time, in my opinion. This is a waste of imagination of a movie. Heck, even saying this as a movie hurts me deeply, because this thing doesn't deserve to be called a movie. It shouldn't even deserve to exist. You know that saying that you should leave old stuff alone? Well, take a look at this. This is exactly why. This is exactly why you should leave old stuff alone. Because if you don't, it will turn into complete and utter garbage. In fact, I don't even know why I call it a movie. It should just be called garbage. It's nothing but garbage. This isn't the Banana Splits. This is a miserably cash grab ripoff of garbage. And you know, this honestly hurts me and offends me that they see this original innocent show as this. Really? Really? Hanna-Barbera would be a shame. You know how Disney is not treating the Muppets properly? Well, that's the same thing with Warner Brothers with Hanna-Barbera. Warner Brothers does not know what to do with Hanna-Barbera anymore. They don't know what to do with it. And if this keeps up, Hanna-Barbera will soon just be nothing but a shattered corpse of what it once was. Take a look at this movie. Take a good look at it. This is a good example of why you should always leave old things alone. And why they should remain in the past. This is exactly why.